Hello, I'm Ted Robbins, and you're about to hear the Derian Dreams Bedtime Story Collection. I hope you're ready to enjoy some incredible stories and share a smile with all the children of Derian House. Rotten Robbin and the Crooked Cutlass by George Kirk, read by me, Ted Robbins. Rotten Robbin was the bravest, the scariest, the fiercest pirate ever to sail in the briny barnacle. But although Rotten Robbin was the bravest, the scariest, the fiercest pirate, he was still only 6 years old, so his mum, Captain Spitwash, wouldn't let him join in with the grown-up pirating yet. He was not allowed to plunder. He was not allowed to swashbuckle, and he could only walk the plank if he was wearing his armbands. One day, Captain Spitwash dropped anchor right next to a small desert island. Their ship, the Briny Barnacle, was in need of repairs, so she was going to dig up some treasure to pay for them. Rotten Robbin wanted to go too, but Captain Spitwash said it was a grown-up pirate job, so she rowed away, leaving him on board with the first mate. "It's not fair!" yelled Rotten Robbin, stamping his foot so hard that, crack, it went right through the rotten timbers, leaving a hole. "Not fair! Not fair!" squawked the first mate, who was, in fact, the ship's parrot. "Oh, shut your beak," grumbled Robbin, as he pulled his foot from the hole. But the first mate did not shut his beak. He opened it even wider. "Ship ahoy! Ship ahoy!" he squawked. Rotten Robbin lifted up his eye patch to look through his telescope. There was a ship approaching, and not just any ship, but the fastest, finest, fiercest ship ever to ride the waves. The Crooked Cutlass. "Oh, no!" said Rotten Robbin. "It's Captain Blunderbuss." Captain Blunderbuss was the most feared pirate of all. Ahoy magazine had rated him first in the 10 most bloodthirsty pirates list for 3 years running. The ship sailed closer and closer. Rotten Robbin could see the fully loaded Captain Blunderbuss standing on deck. His belt was full of pistols, his hands were full of cutlasses, and his sea-frizzed beard was full of daggers. Blunderbuss bellowed and bayed at his crew, who bustled around the 40 fine cannons. "Blunderbuss is going to attack," Robbin told the first mate. "What should we do?" But the first mate was already flying up in a flurry to hide in the crow's nest. Rotten Robbin needed a plan. He looked around. There were plenty of cannonballs on the Briny Barnacle, but only one rusty cannon. And anyway, Captain Spitwash had said that Rotten Robbin was never to play with swords, pistols or matches. So he couldn't fire it. The Crooked Cutlass was sailing closer. There was no need for his telescope now. Robbin could see every scar and scab. He could hear every cheer and sneer, but worse than that, he could smell every burp and belch as it wafted over from the shouting, stinky crew. They waved their weapons while the captain laughed like a lunatic through his blade-filled beard. "I have to save the ship," cried Robbin, but the only other thing he could see was the hole he'd stamped in the ship's deck. "Not that it's worth saving," he complained. "It's falling to bits." And that was the moment Rotten Robbin suddenly had a brilliant idea of how to beat Captain Blunderbuss that wouldn't need matches, swords or even pistols to do it. Robbin grabbed a cannonball, then scrambled up the rigging to hide with the first mate in the crow's nest. The Briny Barnacle seemed tiny in the Crooked Cutlass's shadow. Captain Blunderbuss, seeing no one aboard, gave the order. And all his crew leapt across onto the barnacle's fragile deck. They did not see the small pirate watching them from above. They did not hear the first mate squawk, "Heave ho!" as the last pirate crossed onto the ship. But they saw and heard the cannonball smash through the deck of the Briny Barnacle and the deck below that and through the hull into the sea. Immediately, a beautiful, salty fountain spouted up and the barnacle began to sink. "Avast! Avast!" squawked the first mate as he flew off. Rotten Robbin grabbed a rope from the rigging and swung heroically across from the Briny Barnacle to land lightly on the deck of the Crooked Cutlass. Captain Blunderbuss shook all his cutlasses. "Scuttled by a scurvy sprog," he cried furiously. "It's not fair!" but it was too late. Blunderbuss and his crew sank with the ship into the water. Rotten Robin watched them swim towards the island and saw a surprised Captain Spitwash rowing through them in the other direction. She was even more surprised and delighted to board her brand new ship. "We've been needing a new ship for years," she said. "I just couldn't plunder enough doubloons to buy one." Now she didn't need to pay for ship repairs. They could go and spend the treasure on other things. And the first thing Captain Spitwash bought was Rotten Robin's very first cutlass. After his heroic defeat of Captain Blunderbuss, she decided it was time for Rotten Robin to start swashbuckling. But only for 2 hours, at the weekend, and as long as he was holding her hand. The end.